Sister, I don't know how to pronounce this, Mari Lee, from Finland, emails. MashaAllah, we have people watching in Finland. I've never been to Finland, but we have a sister from Finland saying that she is the only Muslim convert in her family. And all of her family gathers on Christmas. And it is the only time of the year that her family meets. She is the only convert, apparently, from what I understand. She doesn't have a large community or whatever. And she goes online to do her fatwas. And she finds a website. I'm not going to mention it, but it is a website that I'm not too fond of in particular. So she goes on to this website and she says the scholar sitting 5,000 miles away in a land very far from Finland has said that it is sinful for a convert to go to her family or his family, whatever, on the day of Christmas because it is a pagan festival. And she is saying, if I don't go, I will be very sad because my family has accepted my Islam and is the only time I can meet the extended family. And if I do go, I'm going to feel guilty because this fatwa has said that I'm sinful for going. And she has emailed me asking what is my opinion on this.
وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن قَبْلِكَ إِلَّا رِجَالًا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِمْ فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ.
The response to this question, what is prohibited in our religion is to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? لَا أَعْبُدْ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَن تُعْبُدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدْ. What is prohibited is to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those fatawa that you're referencing in those websites, with the respect that they deserve, they don't understand what exactly a family gathering at Christmas is. They have never interacted with a Christian civilization. They are living in a very different world than the ones we inhabit. And so their understanding is skewed. We all know that a family gathering together on the day of Christmas or the night of Christmas Eve, and they come together, is more of a family event. Generally speaking, there's zero religion. And if there is, it'll be one or two phrases at the beginning in the very religious families, and then they'll move on from that. So the claim that attending a family gathering on the night of Christmas is the same as worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a claim that can only come from somebody who is not aware of the realities of the cultures that we are living in. And of course, this is the case here. In my humble opinion, we as Muslims do not celebrate Christmas. That is true. But your case is different. You are not celebrating. Your family is gathering together, as is the culture. And she actually mentions in her email that, in fact, my family don't even believe in Christianity. And I say, even if they did believe in Christianity, it doesn't matter. You are not celebrating Christmas when you go to a family event in your mother and father's house and they're having a family get together. The uncles and aunts are coming. You are the only Muslim of your extended family. With my utmost respect to those scholars who say otherwise, if you're going to tell this only Muslim lady the one time she can meet her family, don't go, then you have no clue what da'wah is in the Western world. You don't understand what it means for a muhajjiba lady or a Muslim lady, a man or woman, the only one, to go and act in a positive manner, show them the beauty of Islam, humanize Islam to your uncles and aunts and second cousins and third relatives. Nobody's going to come together on this day from all over, except on this day, excuse me. And the one day the family is going to come, somebody 5,000 miles away says, oh, it is haram for you to go. No, it is not haram for you to go. Not at all. You are not celebrating Christmas. You are going to fulfill the ties of kinship. That's your niyyah. Make that your niyyah. I'm going to meet my extended family on the one day where the whole family comes together. Now, if your family is going to do a religious ritual before the meal, they're going to invoke a prayer, they're going to say something. At that point in time, you step back, you excuse yourself. Beforehand, you tell them, look, because I'm a new, you know, convert or whatever, I'm not going to participate, if you know them. In this case, she is saying there is no religion whatsoever. They don't even have, as you know, the remnant, I mean, Finland, 70% agnostic anyway. These people, 80%, you know, as we know, in these lands, more Muslims go to Jumu'ah than Christians go to church on Sunday. Muslims are 2-4%. There's more Muslims in Jumu'ah, 2-4% of the population, than the 70% nominal Christians on Sunday. Look at the statistics going on here. So even if they were practicing Christians, when they do something that is related to worshiping Jesus, you do not participate in that. After they're done with that, to sit on the table, to eat with them, to be happy with them, obviously you do not, you know, drink haram, you do not do anything, obviously you avoid anything that is haram to consume, pork or anything. But other than that, your participation in the family festival does not constitute worshipping other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is no hint of servitude to other than Allah in a generic festival of this nature. So make your niyyah to give da'wah, and by da'wah I don't mean you have to pass pamphlets out to your family. I mean your presence, your dignified presence, your akhlaq, your manners. Whoever you were pre-Islam, they're going to see a new you. And that new you will be 1,000 times, 1,000,000 times better than the old you. That is your da'wah right there. And so your participation, far from being haram, I actually say it is mustahab. Go. Go and participate. And your niyyah should be on participating to present what it means to be a Muslim in this society. And inshallah ta'ala, this will be a stepping stone for others to ask you more and more, so that inshallah many of them will be sympathetic to Islam and maybe even beyond this and convert to Islam. So that is the next question. No problem to go to a, and this is for the convert. Obviously the Muslim should not have any festival on their own. That's not what they should do. And the Muslim should not for no reason go to a friend's house on this day. What's the purpose of doing that? We have our culture, we have our civilization. This is the fatwa I'm giving to the convert whose whole family is Christian. In that scenario, it's different. And Allah Azza wa Jalla knows best.
لا يزال الخير حيا لا يزال إن في الدنيا سلاما وظلال أخبر الأيام أنا في وصال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال قم بنا وانظر لآيات الجمال